Students, we are in chapter 3, that is your database management system, and today we are going to discuss question and answers from pages 62 to 65 and 75 to 77. So these are the pages that we are going to discuss by today. First we can have the pages from 62 to 65. Yes, the in that people are having ER model. What is your ER? Yes, it is your entity relationship. Okay, wow. Yes, this model is used to know the concept. What is the actual concept in the database design you are having? That can be seen by this ER model. And this model consists of collection of entities, where each of these entities will be interconnected with each other. Based upon some conditions and dependency, they will be interconnected with each other. Okay, wow. So that is your ER model. Yes, it is going to have mainly three, that is categorized into three, that is your entity, attributes, and the next one it is your relationship. So this is your 5-mark question. What is it? Okay, explain the ER model. It is your 5-mark question. First you have to write these three line, four lines for introduction. Next you go on with the types, that is your entity, attributes, and the next one it is your relationship. Yes, this is your ER model, simply given here. Under entity, you have to write strong entity, weak entity, and the entity instance. So these are all the three types that are available under entity. So this is your attribute. Under attribute, you have to write these 5 points. That is your key attribute, simple attribute, composite attribute, single valid attribute, and the next one it's your multi-valued attribute. And the next, relationship types. Under that you have to write relationship instance, degree of relationship, and the next one it is your cardinality. So these are the points that you people have to write under ER model, and this is your 5-mark question. This is your 5-mark question, and this cardinality alone will be asked for 3 marks for you. It can be asked for your 3 marks. Similarly, attributes alone is asked for your 3-mark question. Attributes can also be asked for 5 marks or 3 marks. As a whole, this ER modeling question is a 5-mark question. Under that, this cardinality is asked as a 3-mark question, and these attributes can be asked for 5 marks and also for your 3 marks. Yes, first we can see the first one. It is your entity. What do you mean by entity? Entity, it can be any real world object. It can be any real world object which is easily identifiable. Identify means you people can be able to easily see that one. For that, you people have to draw this rectangle box. That is your employee. Another one, it is your manager. So this is your definition for entity. Yes, next you people are going to have the types of entity. So totally you are having, yes, next it is your entity instance. So these are the types of entity that are available. Under that one, now first we are going to see the strong entity. A strong, by the name itself you can tell, it is not going to depend upon any other entity. Okay, ma. So by it is, since it is a strong, it is going to have its own primary key. It is going to have its own primary key, and it is represented by a rectangle. So you people know what is a primary key. It is a 3-mark question for you. Okay, ma. So this entity is represented by a rectangle for you. So these are the points that you have to write under strong entity. Okay, wow. So the next one, it is your weak entity. Weak means, by the name itself, you people will be able to understand. It is going to depend upon any other entity. It is going to depend upon any other entity. Yes, the first point is a weak entity depend on any other entity. So the strong entity is going to have primary key of its own. But this weak entity does not have its own primary key. It is represented by double rectangle for you. It is represented by double rectangle. Next, you have to draw this diagram. The third one, it is your entity instance. Okay, ma. Instance is nothing but these are the values for the entity. Instance are nothing but are the values for the entity. Okay, ma. Entity instance denotes the category. For which category it is belong, that is represented in entity instance. So this is your example. So under the category animals, you will be having dog, cats, lion, that are available under the category animal. For jobs, you will be having engineer, doctor, lawyer. Electronics, under electronics you will be having laptop, mobile. So main thing, under that you are going to have the remaining values. So the entity act as a category for you and the instance act as a value for you. So these are the three types that are available under entity. Okay, one. And next two people are going to write the next one. It is your attribute. The next one, it is your attribute. What is an attribute? Attribute is the information about the entity. About the entity, if you people are going to or willing to give the information, that is your attribute. So in that information, what it is going to do? It describes the quantity, quality, and classify and specify the entity. So quantity means how much it is going to have. Quality, how better it is. Classify means it is going to differentiate. Specify, it is going to name that one. So that is your attribute. An attribute will always have a single value. Attribute will have only a single value. It will not have any many values. Values, how the values can be? Values can be a number or character or string. Okay, wow. Value can be a number or character or string. So an attribute is the information about the entity. It describes, which one describes? Attribute describes the quantity, quality, classify and specify an entity. An attribute will always have a single value. Values can be a number or character or string. So this is your introduction that you got to write under attributes. And next, these are the types of attributes that are available. These are the types of attributes that are available. First one, it is your key attribute, simple. Next one, composite. Next one, single valued. And the next one, it is your multi-valued attributes. So these are the types of attributes that are available. First, we can see the key attribute. Yes, it describes a unique characteristics of an entity. Unique means something, for each and everything, something will be different, no? So that it is going to represent means it is your key attribute. A key attribute describes the unique characteristics of an entity. Next, we are going to see the next one. It is your simple attribute. Simple attribute is, a simple attribute cannot be separated. It will be behaving a single value for their entity. So under entity, employee is the entity and employee name is the attribute for you. So this point you have to write under simple attribute. So this is your diagram for, that is your diagram example for simple attribute. Yes, next you people are going to have the composite. Composite means many attributes together. So subdividing the composite attribute, it act as a simple attribute and it will be having meaning also. It will be having the meaning also. Okay, but that is your composite attribute. A composite attribute can be subdivided into simple attributes without changing the meaning of that attribute. Without changing the meaning of the attribute, you are going to have the subdivided attributes of composite attribute. The next one, it is your single valued attribute. By the name itself, this attribute is going to have only one value and it do not have multiple values. So for this one, what could be your example? Yes, a person's age can be your example for single valued attribute, that is here. Yes, the single valued attributes, here you are having the age. Age 3, and the roll number, it can be 85. So for a person, you can have a single degree. Okay, wow. Yes, this is your single valued attribute. The next one, it is your multi-valued attribute. Multi-valued attribute, that is, for a single attribute, it is going to have many values. It is going to have many values. Yes, here. A single person can have many bank accounts. Similarly, a single person can have many degree also. Okay, wow. This is your example for multi-valued attribute. So by now we finished what are the attributes. First we finished the introduction, that is your definition like. And next we finish what are the types of attributes that are available. So totally 5 attributes are available for you. Okay, wow. Yes, key, composite. Next one, single valid attribute, multi-valid attribute, and the next one, it is your, Yes, the next one, it is your simple attribute. So key attribute, simple attribute, composite attribute. Next one, it is your single valid attribute. And the next one, it is your multi-valid attribute. So these are the points, types of attributes that are available. Yes, next we are going to have the relationship types. So don't forget, it is your 5-mark question. The main three headings are entity, attribute, and next one, it is your relationship type. Each heading can also be asked for 3 mark. As a whole, it is your 5 mark. Under that, now we are going to see the third one. It is your relationship type. It is your relationship type. So when you will be having relationship, when there is two entities, you will be having a relationship. So relationship exists between two entities. So here you are having three types of relationships. Okay, wow. The first one, it is your one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, many-to-many relationship. So already in the theory class, I have explained this one with your diagram. So by now, we are going to have only the theory alone. Okay, wow. Relationship exists between two entities. Three types are there. Three types are given here. First one, it is your one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, many-to-many relationship. First one is one-to-one. Okay, wow. Here they have described that one with an example for you. Next one, it is your one-to-many. That is one. It is going to have relationship with many things that exist in B entity. Here how they have explained is that you are going to have A entity and the next one, it is your B entity. So entity one means from A, you are going to have one. It is going to have relationship with N entities. That is many entities that are available under B. It is going to have many values, that is your one to many. Many to many means from A also many things is going to have relationship, many relationship with that are values that are available under B. Okay, wow. So these you will be having under relationship type. First one is one to one relationship, one to many relationship, and the next one, it is your many to many relationship. Okay, wow. You see, in reality, one to one are less used. One to one are less used. One to many and many to many are commonly used. And to generally to tell, many to many are converted into one to many relationship. Many to many relationships are converted into one to many relationship. As a whole, we can tell one to many relationships are mainly used, remaining are rarely used. Okay, wow. This is your relationship type. Next, you people are going to have the next one, that is your relationship instance. Instance means, yes, each instance already we have discussed, it's your value of the relationship between the members of these entity type is called a relationship instance. Okay, wow. The next, it is your degree of relationship. So number of entity types involved is known as degree of relationship. Number of entity types involved is known as your degree of relationship. That is, one is unary, two means binary, and three means ternary. So this is your example. This you will be having under example. So go on with this one. It is your relationship instance. This point you will have to write under relationship types. Okay, ma'am. Yes, next we finish the degree of relationship. Next we are going to see the next one. That is your cardinality. Okay, ma'am. Yes, what do you mean by cardinality? Yes, it is defined as the number of items that must be included in a relationship. So in a relationship, how many number of items that you people are going to use, if it is going to be defined, means that is called as your cardinality. That is known as your cardinality. So here you are going to have three classification, that is your one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-many. So under the relationship we finished now, that heading only, here it is going to be explained with the example for you. See this diagram. So at a time, one person can drive a vehicle. Person drives vehicle. Only one person can drive a vehicle at a time. So it is your one-to-one. The next one, it is your one-to-many. It is your one-to-many. That is, a single customer can place many order. He can purchase many product at a time, or he can order many food items at a time in a hotel. So that is customer places order. So here it is given as N. N means it can be ranges from two to many as is wished by the customer. Okay, va? And the next one it is your many to many. Many to many students register course. Many students will be registering many course at a time. Okay, va? So that is your many to many relationship. So cardinality is, it is going to define the number of items. Here it is your one item number one. Here the item is n. Here also the item is n. So it is going to define the number of items that is available used in the relationship, means that is called as your cardinality. Here you are having three classification, that is one to one, one to many, and the next one it is your many to many. It can be simply told or visualized by means of this example. Okay, va? One person drives one vehicle at a time. Customer, one customer places many order. And the next one it is your many student register many course. Many student register many course. Clear with this one? Yes, these are the points that you people have to write under ER modeling. You have to write under ER modeling. Cardinality alone will be asked for 3-mark question. Cardinality alone will be asked for 3-mark question. Yes, next we can see the next one. It is your designing databases. It is your designing databases. Yes, what is designing database? The process of creating, implementing and maintaining the enterprise data in a system is known as designing of database. The process, the steps so that are needed in creating, implementing and maintaining. Okay, wow. So that is called as your designing of database. So the performance success of an application depends upon the good design. Good design only will bring success. Okay, wow. So the good design is most important. So the performance success of an application depends on good database design. So this is your 2-mark question, that is define designing databases. Yes, next it is your conceptual design. So primary phase in database design where the discussion happens about the creation of databases, tables, columns and data types. So this you have to write under what is conceptual design. And next, what are the three major parts that forms a database? Means table, queries, views. The three major parts that forms a database is table, queries, view. Table means it is going to have multiple rows and column. Each row is a record and each column is an attribute. That is your table. Query means it is going to ask some questions. Questions will be having some conditions also. The next one, it is your views. Views is a set of stored query. View is nothing but it is your set of stored query. So what are the parts that forms a database means? You have to write these three. So it is your 3-mark question. Next, you people are going to discuss some example. The first example is to create a database. Yes, create to store the personal details. So the database is create database personal details. So create database, it is your functions. That is your inbuilt function. Okay, wow. So that is your keywords. This is the personal details, it is your database name. After entering this, you will be having this message, that is query OK, one row affected message will be displayed. If this message is not displayed, means there is problem with this syntax or problem with the table database. This database will not be available for you. Okay, wow. After creating that one, what you people are going to do? You are going to use this database. Why you have to use this one? Many databases will be available, no? From that you are going to use that one that you have created by now. For that only you are using the command use personal details. Next line you will be having the command. After typing this line and pressing the enter key, you will be having this one, that is your database change. Then you can go on with the next step also, that is you can check whether your database is really created or not. So for that one, what is the syntax you are having? Show databases. So this database will list all the available database that is available in your system, that is in your database server. So here it is having your personal details. So it is created and now you people are using the personal details database. So this is a simple syntax that is used to create a create a database. Yes, next we are going to see the next one, create table. Create table in an application, each page reveals some functionality. Each functions are designed to a table. Each and every functions are designed to a table for you. Next, create columns. Column is something related to the table. Already people know table is a collection of rows and column. Okay, wow. So each table will have many columns related to the functionality, related to the requirement of the table. There will be many columns. So column determines what values are stored in the table. Column is going to determine what values or how many values are going to be stored in the table. The next one, it is your insert rows. Insert row means, so column is created, for that column you have to give some value, so that is your insert rows. So see here, one databases are created, columns with a value type are defined. Column database is created, table is created, table is created with a column ID. Next you people have to insert the records to the table. Next you have to, after creating everything, records are to be inserted to the table. That is your insert row. So this is your syntax for insert into table name. Yes, insert into table name. Okay, wow. This is the table name that you have created. Yes, column one, for each, how many columns you people are having, enter that column name. For each and every column you people are going to give the values. That is your values, value 1, value 2, value 3, value 4. Based upon the column, the value will be changing for you. Okay, wow. Yes, next one, it is your SQL. SQL is structured query language. Already you people know the definition for SQL. It is your standard language. It is your standard language declared in the standard year 1986 and 87 by which organization? ANSI, that is your American National Standards Institute, that is ANSI. And the next one, it is your ISO. It is your International Organization for Standardization. Don't forget, it is your language, standard language. It is not your database. SQL is not your database. It is your standard language used for accessing and manipulating database. Yes, these are the functions of SQL. First one, it execute the query. The next, it retrieves data. Next, it inserts and update record. Next, it can delete record. Next, it can create new database and new tables. Don't forget, tables are created in a database only. Okay, wow. So these are the functions of the SQL. First one, it can execute query, retrieves data. Next one, insert and update record. Next one, delete record. And the next, it can create new database and new tables in a database. So these, it is your 2 mark question. Yes, these are the types of SQL commands. Totally 5 types you are having: DDL, DML, TQL, TCL, and the next one, it is your DCL. Yes, the first one, it is your DDL. It is your data definition language. By the name itself, it is going to define the schema or structure. It is going to define the schema, that can be called by the name structure, that's all. Create and modify the structure of the database objects in the database. It is going to create and modify. That is your DDL. Under that, it is going to have commands like create, alter, drop, rename, truncate. So these are the commands that are available under DDL. Okay, wow. So it, as a whole, it is asked for 5 mark question. Okay, wow. What are the types? So types of SQL commands, as a whole it is asked for a 5 mark question, and DDL, that is your data definition language, separately it is asked for a 3 mark question. Similarly, each and everything is separately asked for a 3 mark question also. If it is asked separately, you have to write the expansion. Next, write down the points, that is your introduction points, and next you must write what are the commands that are available along with the explanation. You have to write the commands that are available along with the explanation. So first command that is available under DDL is create. By the name itself, you are going to create a database or a table. alter. Alter means you are going to do some changes. The next one, it is your drop. Drop is, it is going to delete. Rename, it is going to rename already existing thing in the database. Truncate, it is used to delete all table records. It is going to use to delete all. Already you are having a drop. Okay, why? It deletes a database or table. Here it is going to delete all table records. Truncate means it will delete all the records for you. And the next one, it is your data manipulation language. Manipulating means doing some calculation. So many SQL commands are under DML commands only. Yes, these are the commands for you. Insert, update, delete. Under that one, we have already discussed the syntax for insert also. Insert into table. What are the parameters? Next, value, value 1, value 2, like that we discussed, no? Yes, many SQL will be coming under DML commands only. Yes, that are insert, it going to add new rows into database table. Update, modifies the existing data. Update means already you know, some changes will be there. It is going to modify that one. Delete, delete the record from the table. It is going to delete the record from the table. These and all you will be having under your data manipulation language. Next, it is your data query language. Query, just it is going to ask some question. Okay, wow. So under that you are having only one command. It is your select. It is going to retrieve the data from the table. So select is the only command that is available under DQL. DQL is data query language. It is used to fetch the data from the database tables. Yes, next one, it is your transaction control language. That is your TCL. Transaction means some changes you people will be doing, no? So that is controlled by this language. It is your TCL. These commands are going to manage the transactions. It helps to change, save the changes permanently. It helps to save the changes permanently into the database. So here that are the commands that are available. First one, it is your commit. Next one, rollback. Next one, set transaction, and the next one, it is your save point. Don't forget, what are the commands that are available in the TCL will save your changes permanently for you. First one, it is your commit, permanent save into database. Next one, it is your rollback. Rollback means getting it back, okay, wow. Restore database to original form since the last commit. But recent or commit panirpamla munnakuti varaikkulladhu enna panikala restore panikala na you can people can get back. Next one, it is your set transaction. Set transaction property, it is going to set it as read write or read only. Read means you can read it, and similarly you people can change it, that is you can write it. Otherwise you are going to only read that one. That is set by means of set transaction command. Next, you are having the save point. Save point is, it is used to temporarily save. Means you can use save point. So these are the commands that are available under TCL. That is your transaction control language. Yes, next we are going to see is data control language. Next we are going to see is data control language. By the name itself, something is going to control the data. Here you are going to have the commands that are going to control the data. So these commands implement security on the database. What are the database objects like table, view, stored, procedure? So what are the commands that are available? Only two commands are available. That is your grant, and the next one is your revoke. Grant means by the name itself you can. It is going to give some permission. So that is your grant. Revoke means it is going to take away the permission. So that is your, so it is going to take away the permission, that is your revoke. Okay, wow. Grant is nothing but it is used to give permission to the specific user, and revoke means it is used to take out permission from the specific user. That is your grant and revoke. So these points you have to write under SQL DCL command. That is your data control language. Okay, wow. So clear with the commands that we have discussed by now. So these are the commands that you are having under SQL. So what are the types of SQL commands means? You have to go on with the 5 commands that are available. It can also be asked separately for 3-mark question. So these are the points, questions that we have discussed under the pages that I have specified yearly for you. So remaining pages we can continue in the next class. Yes, thank you students.